गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. लास्ट क्लास में हमने डिस्कस किया था कि पेज लेआउट और लिंकिंग क्या होती हैं, और उसको थोड़ा सा रिकॉल कर लेते हैं. वेबसाइट इज कंसिस्ट ऑफ एज वी ऑल नो इंडिविजुअल वेब पेजेस दैट आर लिंक टुगेदर यूजिंग अ वेरियस नेविगेशनल लिंक. सो पेज लेआउट एक्चुअली डिफाइंस द विजुअल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द पेज एंड डिवाइड द पेज एरिया इनटू द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स टू प्रेजेंट द इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफ वेरिंग इंपॉर्टेंस. पेज लेआउट ऑल्सो अलाउ द डिजाइनर टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट द कंटेंट इन अ पेज सच दैट विजिटर कैन व्यू इट ईजिली एंड फाइंड नेसेसरी डिटेल्स. सो वाइल डिजाइनिंग द पेज लेआउट डिजाइनर शुड कीप some of the points in their minds. I will discuss one by one. While distributing the content in layout, balance between the text and graphic is required. Too much of graphics may lead to slow down the pages. So locate the item on the page using screen importance to attract the user attention. Important item. Maintain consistency among the layout of the pages such that it creates cohesive design and website matching to your particular theme. So once the page layout prepared, we have to link them together to provide the navigation path consistently so that user can find desired information easily and quickly. So these are the things that we have already discussed. Now, what is sitemap? A sitemap is a blueprint of your website that helps search engine to scroll and index all your website content. Sitemap also tells search engine which page on your website are most important. Some of the major type of sitemaps are there. जैसे हम बात करते हैं नॉर्मल XML sitemap की, जो कि लिंक करता है आपके डिफरेंट वेब पेजेस को ऑन योर वेबसाइट. वीडियो sitemap होते हैं जो कि गूगल को हेल्प करते हैं कि वो अंडरस्टैंड कर सके वीडियो कंटेंट ऑन योर वेब पेज. कुछ न्यूज sitemap होते हैं विच हेल्प यूजर to find content outside that are approved for a Google News. Kuch image sitemaps hote hain jo ki help karte hain Google ko to find out all of the images hosted on your website. So is type ke jo sitemaps hote hain, iski madad se jo bhi aapke search engine hote hain wo ranking decide karte hain aapki website ki. Search engine like Google, Yahoo, etc. uses sitemap to find different web pages of your website. If your site pages are properly linked, our web scroller can usually discover most of your website. A sitemap, or we can say XML sitemap, is a list of different pages of the website, and XML is short for extensible markup language, which is a way to display information on your site. So we can say that sitemap is very important part of your website, which tell the search engine the location of your page on your website, when it was updated and updating frequently, and the importance of the page as it related to the other page on your website. Without a proper sitemap, Googlebot might think that your website has duplicate content, which will actually hurt the SEO ranking. So sometimes you should properly link your web pages, and the proper navigation should be keep in sitemap so that the ranking of your website will enhanced. The first thing you need to do is look at the existing content on your website and see how everything is structured. Okay, look at sitemap template and figure out how your web page should be displayed on the table. This is very basic structure of your website. It all starts from home page. Then you have to ask yourself where your home page linked to, or you like already have this figured out based on the menu option on your website. But when it comes to SEO, search engine optimization, not all pages are created equally. You have to keep the depth of your website in mind when you are doing this. Recognize the page further away from your website homepage will be harder to rank for. You should aim to create a sitemap that has shallow depth, meaning it also takes 3 to 4 clicks to navigate to any page of your website. Okay, for a much better SEO purpose, you need to create a hierarchy of the pages based on importance and how you want them to be indexed. So the priority of the content should also need to create. This is the overview of the sitemap. So basically the sitemap is a file of a code that lives on your web server and lists all of the relevant URLs on your website is carrying. Your website helps search engine web crawler understand how your website is built so that they can evaluate and rank it more easily. Okay, people create sitemap when they first design this website, their website, add pages to it and redesign it. It's a kind of like a floor plan of the for the site, which comes in a handle whenever the site gets changed. Along with the boosting search engine optimization, sitemap can also help to design a site navigation scheme so you can avoid the internet linking issues. So sitemap itself play a very important role during the designing of any kind of website. Okay, so next point is user-centric website. We also need to discuss. Yes, user-centric design. User-centric design is nothing. It simply means that you should need to design your website in that manner that every user can able to search the required content very easily. That means you are providing the familiar environment and friendly environment for the user. As whenever you design any website, you should keep in mind that you are the developer, so it become very easy for you to recognize or remember the structure of your website. But for a new user, it become very difficult for them to recognize every time the pattern of your website, the structure of your website, to retrieve the information. So proper navigation should be there so that user can get their required information in 2 to 3 clicks. So you must design your website as a user-centric design. So as a developer, it also become difficult for us to satisfy all of the user. So just keep in mind that you need to design your website in a standard form that it should support at least 2 to 3 browser. It should be very friendly for any kind of machine, like latest machine or older machine. So proper navigation should be there. So these are the basic thing that you should keep in your mind using designing your website. Now the planning and the publishing of the website, what is that? We have already discussed the planning of the website, that the when you design any website, initially you should design the planning of the website, which includes the proper objective of the website. You should find out the targeted audience as well. You should also plan for the page layout, page linking, sitemap. These all the important points that comes in the planning part. And now the publishing of the website. So publishing of the website, we can say that if you in order to publish your website, you need the some of the important thing, like first is web development software, second is internet connection, and third is web server. So what is web development software? It is the use of building web pages of your website, like GVS, like WordPress, etc. These are the software which is needed by the developer to design any website. Now, web server is actually the location where your website resides on, and web server may host a single or multiple site depending on what hosting services you have to pay for. Domain name is a part of your internet address that comes from www. So domain name is also required. A domain name become your business address, you can say, or it should be taken to select the domain name. It should be easy to remember it. So there are so many domain name extensions are there. The final letter that end of the internet address is known as the top level domain name, as they are called the top level because they are read it from the right to left. So the part after the dot is the highest highest level in the hierarchy, like .com, .edu, .gov, .int, .mil, .net, .org, etc. These are the higher level hierarchy. Now, registering domain name. How you can able to register your domain name? We will discuss one by one. First is, think of the name that justify your business need. To find out the available name, you can enter a name at a commercial domain name registered, such as GoDaddy. So from here, you can find out the commercial domain name if it is available, required by you. If the domain name entered UR is available, then select that particular domain name. Now it will the task for you for other additional services such as email, inbox, hosting, etc. you want or not, that hosted also provide. You may choose it, and now they will ask you for your personal information to store in the database. It will then ask you for the payment information, and when you're done with the payment, and the above steps you need to follow, and after that you can able to upload your stuff and use all the tools provided by that particular GoDaddy websites. And so these are the steps through which you can able to publish your website. And effective design, effective navigation is simply the proper navigation that developers should keep in their website to provide the user to retrieve the information. Like if you take an example of Myntra or any other fashion website, they, when you click on the particular picture that they are showing, you will able to get that required information for which you are searching of. So this is the image, is actually the navigation image which led the user to get to that information which is required by it. So use these proper kind of navigation. If you talk about some educational website, they are showing their links of upcoming events properly on the home page. So it becomes very easy for the user to click on those provided navigation and retrieve the proper information. So effective navigation should be there for any website so that user can able to retrieve the information in the limited amount of time. So this is all for unit 1, and from tomorrow we will discuss the important points of unit 2, and we will see the coding part of HTML. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me in message. Thank you.